Hello, everybody. It's the Poltergeist 5000 with a fresh LP. Yeah, I know, like, what? But, yeah, so Banjo Kazooie is, taking a while because scheduling conflicts and, extremely inopportune times for the internet to go out. So, I'm gonna play Mega Man 7 in the meantime, because I don't wanna just give up on the whole click-clockwood fuck. Click-clockwood co-com. You know, the CCCCC. Good grief, man. So this is Mega Man 7. This intro cutscene is a little more in-depth than previous ones, which is exactly why I'm talking over it like a dumbass. Dr. Wily always knew his schemes might end in... failure, and had planned for just such an occasion with this newest batch of Robot Masters, the most badass Robot Masters to ever exist. Four had been hidden away, and after 6 months, 6 months without being contacted by Dr. Willy, oh, oops, they activate, present tense, and begin searching for their master. Oh no. You know what's weird is that there's this dude, but I don't think this guy is supposed to be one of the original four Robot Masters that got activated. This guy's like the boss of the intro stage, and yet, well, is he one of the four? But then you start the game with four Robot Masters, so what's up with that? Oh, he's breathing fire! Who designs these things? He looks like he was designed by Lord Boxman. Like, what's going on here? And why is he breathing? Oh no, my face! My face! My beautiful face! Mega Man 7! What? Boy, look at this epic title screen with a perfect triangle in the background. It's not quite isosceles, because it's like a triangle where one line is all horizontal and the other ones are at 45 degree angles. So it's not isosceles. I think it is isosceles, because isosceles is uneven, right? It's not equilateral. That's the one where they're all equal. Can't this thing go any faster, Otto? The city is under attack. I remember Tim's LB said, yeah, Jesus Christ, man. I'll try and punch it up a notch. Hold on, Roll.
I can't believe Wily is loose again. Won't this madman ever stop?
He won't be loose for long. Once Dr. Light gives Rush and me our new enhancements, Wily is history. This game is awesome. Whoa, end of the line. The road is too unstable to keep going. Well, that sucks. You two wait here. You two losers. Mega Man, take this helmet with you. Oh, this is my favorite fucking part. Not this, but what happens right after it. Gives him a mental helmet and he's like, I don't know about this, man. That's pretty weird. And then Otto says, you know, I guess not. Personally, I kinda like the other one. And I always imagine him, like, looking towards the camera and quirking an eyebrow as he says that. Personally, and then he looks at the camera and does the DreamWorks face. I kinda like the other one. And then, like, the trailer, and then the music starts playing, and they do, like, the badass action montage in the movie trailer, you know? Oh no, Dr. Light! It's like a screen away. The doctor, are you okay? I'll bring back Roll to take care of you. I have seen this text very little in my life. No, Mega Man, we have no time. Wily is using the attack, I forget my voice, of his robots to cover his escape. Look! And he points, like, in the background. It bugs me how, like, these things, they curve, but they aren't centered on the top of the building. Like, you see the ladder two went further to the side, and they were all further to the left. Oh no, it's Wily, and he's wiggling his eyebrows. That's a fancy... How'd he get a UFO in prison? Did they bring it with them? I don't know. You've got to go now, Mega Man. Get Rush, and follow Wily's spaceship. Yeah, that the first couple lines of... Oh geez, we're playing The Feud! The first couple lines of that Dr. Light dialogue, I have seen very few times in my life, because most of the time I've seen this game, it's been because I've been watching Nintendo Capri Sun's LP of it. But in that LP, he put up a caption on screen that covered the dialogue at the beginning of that cutscene. So I never knew what he was saying there. Oh, here come the boss man. This guy looked a lot bigger in the opening cutscene. Maybe this is a smaller model with like the neck, with like the last, the other one, like the Guts Dozer in the Wily Fortresses or something. It's ironic that I would say that, actually, considering one of the bosses you do fight fulfills one of those conditions. You'll never guess which one it is. Ow, my body. I hate when this guy pounds the ground. Ow, no! He pounds the ground and then you can't jump. But yeah, we actually keep going after this guy dies. That's weird. There's more level here. This music has awesome game. So I can't wait to... Oh no, it's bass! It's actually bass. I don't know why. It's just funny to say bass. Because bass has that stupid A sound. You know, like I gotta go to class so I can fight bass. You know? It's the same A sound that's in like the word. Dude, holy crap, this guy's a badass.
You are as good as they say, Mega Man. Do you get it? My voice is a bass.
You better tell me who you are, question mark.
I'm bass, and he's treble. We have been trying to stop Dr. Wily while you were gone.
Jacking off. I don't know why. That's so funny when Tim says that in his LP.
I see now that you don't need our help.
Okay. Bass? Why are the periods in the middle of the line? That's weird. Is it because I'm a robot? Anyway. Here's the password screen. I don't know. Anyway. I was trying to think of something funny to say, and I just came up with completely nothing. Just nothing. There was just nothing. So here's the four Robot Masters. You might think, well, what the heck, man? I thought there were supposed to be 8 Robot Masters. Well, don't worry. The other 4 will show up again later. But that actually kind of sucks, because it means that there's only really one way to follow the weakness order. You have to start with Burst Man, which is this guy down here. And also, they don't show the names. What's up with that, right? Well, this guy's Burst Man. And Burst Man's strong against Cloud Man, who's strong against Junk Man, who's strong against Freeze Man. You would never guess that Junk Man is strong against Freeze Man. You would think it would be Turbo Man, because he gives you a flame weapon. But nope, it's Junk Man. Well, I think the flame shield also is effective on Freeze Man. But whatever, let's just do Burst Man. Let's just get on with it here. Seriously. Look at this guy. He looks like something. Isn't there a character? Zero. Zero in the Mega Man X series has, like, the exact same torso as Burst Man with the two, like, bubble nipples, you know? Can't think of a nastier word to use in conjunction with nipples than bubble. Like, ugh. That's exactly what you don't want your nipples being. Anyway. One unfortunate thing about this game is that the charging sound effect really grates on the grain after a while. Grates on the old grain. No, I don't know what that means. Now, I think we do start with Rush Coil in this game. Yes, we do. It doesn't change your color, but I can get this Wanoop! Another 1-Up! Oh, shoot, should I bring back the 1-Up counter for this? I guess I probably should. Oh, no, I fell down. Oh, man, I really wish I would rather have that than the life I picked up. Jeez. Tell you what, man, it bothers me a little bit that the explosions in this game or the explosions from these, like, platforms here, they don't actually, like... Yep. What? They don't actually, they aren't perfectly circular all the way around. They're like, you know, whatever game has that with their boss explosions, where, like, one of the, I think it's Mega Man 3, like, one quarter of the clock, the stuff doesn't, the explosion doesn't happen as quickly on one quarter of the animation, which is really awkward. It's probably Mega Man 3. We all know that's probably the least well-programmed Mega Man. Anyway. Got a craft here. You like the craft? Meaty! Anyway. Is this guy gonna do his whoop? This guy has a thing where he can... Oh, no! This is kind of a game... A lot of the time in this game, you'll find yourself just kind of tanking hits, because not a lot of stuff in this game doesn't do that much damage. Yeah, just avoid that. Oh, and now you start... Once you beat Mr. Crab Dude, the water changes color, or whatever this is supposed to be, the goop changes color. And now you're floating up. I don't know if you noticed or not, but yeah. Ooh, slow down. Get some more toilet paper. How are you supposed to get? Oh, okay. It's like, how are you supposed to get that? And then the game immediately answered my question. This looks like, you know what this looks like? This looks like the syrup I was just making, like, this morning. Because we got a bag of lemons recently, and I was like, oh man, I want to make something with these lemons. Because I saw, like, on Tasty, they did a recipe for grilled lemonade, where they just, like, put it on the grill, and it caramelizes the sugar, so it gets, like, this nice, like, it gives, like, this nice toasty, sugary flavor to it. Anyway, yep, there we go. Got the Yoku blocks here. I tried doing that. It didn't really work. Oh, balls. Okay, can I actually make this jump up onto this thing? Yeah, I can. This game isn't quite as merciless with its Yoku blocks as a lot of games in the series. Mega Man 9. Or, it's gotta be some... Well, hell, Mega Man 2! What the hell am I talking about Mega Man 9 when it comes to merciless Yoku blocks? Look no further than the very second end in the series. That's where all the worst Yoku block sequences are. Fucking Heat Man, I tell you what, man. Get out of here, man. Ow! You hit me in the forehead. What is this, David and Goliath? That was barely qualified as a joke. I'm out. Peace. Oh, baby, that was slick. I feel happy about that. I want that screw! This is the first game we've played that actually has screws. And basically what screws are is their currency. There's actually a shop that you can access from the stage select screen. I think you just hit select. It's a shop that's run by Otto, the dude from the opening cutscene. And he'll sell you junk, and you just gotta supply him with the screws, and he'll make stuff. Got these things. Weren't those things in, like... Those things are kind of like... They're from Mega Man 3, I guess, but they act a lot more, like, realistically. Anyway, here's Burst Man, the first Robot Master. The Robot Masters in this game... This is kind of when Robot Master started to have attack patterns that were very robotic, which is appropriate, but, you know. Anyway. I really hate this. Ugh. This is awkward, because I've got, like, a half second of lag. I don't know why, but I do... Basically, you just gotta do this, and when you hit this guy with a charge shot... The thing about the bosses in this game is hitting them with a weapon, hitting them with a... I think it's like hitting them with a charge shot or hitting them with their weapon causes them... It can disrupt their patterns. Like, fighting a boss Buster only is gonna give you a totally different battle than fighting them with their weakness, because hitting them with their weakness usually resets their attack pattern, so they only ever get to use, like, their first attack. Which is really awkward. But anyway. See, like, I don't know if I didn't hit this guy with a Mega Buster shot after he lets out those bubbles, I don't know if he'd do the same stuff. I don't know if he would just do this again, or if he would do something else. This is actually a game that I really like doing Buster only, except for one boss. Fucking Slash Man. Fuck that boss fight. That guy is such a pile of shit. Like... That guy is, like, one of the most nebulous fucking boss fights I've ever fought in my life. Yeah, you tell that asshole. Did I take a single hit in that whole level? Yeah, I did. I got hit by the craft. Yeah, geez, you didn't do that whole stage without getting hit. What are you thinking? You weren't that good at this. I'm not even that good at this. Like, I don't think of myself as good at this game. I mean, hell, I should be able to beat Slash Man Buster only, you know? The Danger Rat fires out a bomb encased in a bubble, doesn't it? Yes, but it can also be used to encase other things besides bombs. Along with the bomb, so you know, like halfway from point A to point B, the bubble's gonna explode with whatever cargo you were transporting, making it kinda useless in that situation. But anyway, you got Danger Rat. You get another password. You guys have for one more stage? Let's go to Cloud Man. This guy's got happy music. That music is so fucking good, man. Look at this motherfucker. Look at this guy. Look at this, like, fucking, like, matryoshka-looking dude. I don't know what else to call him. He's like one of those toys that, like, is weighted on the bottom, so it always stands up straight. You know what I'm talking about? Does anyone know what I'm talking about? I don't. Hang on. These guys in this level... These guys, weren't these in some other Mega Man game? Mega Man game? I could swear, maybe it was just a fan game, but I could swear these things were in another Mega Man game somewhere. Rockman 4 minus Infinity, maybe? you hit that guy and it starts raining. You can actually get around that guy without causing it to start raining, but it's really easy to get knocked into the pit, so I wouldn't bother. And it doesn't... There's no benefit to, like, keeping it all... Whoop. Oh, you know what I should do, actually? Oh, man. I shouldn't be following the weakness order so closely. Because I'm not worried about fighting Robot Masters. Because I plan on doing Buster-only runs of everybody I'm able to. So because I'm doing that, it would be really easy for me to show off a lot of cool stuff in this game. Like the fact that if you come here with Freeze Man's weapon, you can do something in this stage with that second guy there, that second umbrella dude. You can actually do something with him. You can make it snow if you hit him with Freeze Man's weapon. And it looks really cool, and it's like all cuckoo-feeling inducing because snow is beautiful. And there's going to be a part of the stage, well, I won't spoil it, but there's going to be a part of the stage where if having it snowing is actually a great goal, grand old, good old, bad old help. Because it allows you to see what you're doing a lot better. I know that sounds fucking weird, like why would it being snowing allow you to see better? Well, just wait. You know how, like, in the crystal caves in Dark Souls, you can tell by, like, the snowflakes landing where the invisible platforms are? Well, okay, so here you can see, we got this platform here that you can't really see except for this little area around Magan Man. If it was snowing, we would be able to see everything. Like we would be able to see the platforms because the snow would be on top. Where's that? There's a platform, like, up above somewhere here. Ugh. 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 Okay, here we go. Okay, so those guys are like the birds in Mega Man 2. They drop that egg, and then it hatches into a whole bunch of dudes. But the thing about this game is that you got the Mega Buster in this game. Okay, now this is tricky. I think you have to use Rush Coil here. Yeah, and you can shit. Fuck! Okay. Man, what are the odds of that? Yeah, so what you can do in this game... Oh. What? It's not raining anymore. Oh, this is cool. Holy crap. This is so freaking cool, man. Have I never died in the second half of this stage before? Because I didn't know you could get this to be, like, not stormy. This is so, like, nice. And I love rainy weather, so this is weird. It feels weird coming out of my mouth saying it's nice that it's not stormy, considering how much I love rainy weather. Anyway. Oh, I can actually see what I'm doing. Holy cow. Yeah, so what you can do... well, I fucked it up there because I jumped. But is, If you charge up a Mega Buster shot and then let it loose, like, right when the egg hatches, you can kill every enemy in the egg at once and get, like, a whole bunch of drops. Which is pretty much the best way to grind for drops in this game. Okay, so here we go. There we go. And here's the U. So normally you would get that by... The only way you would ever know that these platforms are actually here would be if it was snowing and you could see them because of the snow on the platforms. Oh, this isn't good. This is less than good. Jump. Avoid that. Slide over here. Smooth. Okay, now can I make this jump all the way over here? Nope, I'm just gonna land there. I would have fallen in the fucking pit. Aw, damn it, if I'd gone for that jump all the way over there. And Sniper Joe.
Those are called Hammer Joes. They'll swing their mighty hammer around and then throw it. So you better watch your back.
I already know this. Anyway. Sniper Joes in this game look pretty cool. I love how, if you've ever played Rockman 4 minus Infinity, they actually took the sprite of Sniper Joes from this game and used them as, like, super badass Mega Sniper Joes for one of the Dr. Wily bosses. And that was a really easy boss, though, because that whole level was the gimmick was vehicles. Nope, we got a special thing here. It's Proto Man! Hello, Proto Man, like Chozo Ghost, don't Tony know. It's been a while, Mega Man. Here is a little information. Your weapons can be used to discover hidden areas. Try using the flame weapon in the woods. Okay. Cool. Goodbye. Let's get out of here. I'm still have Rush Coil equipped. Let's turn that off. This jump is actually deceptively hard to make to get the screw. Yeah. This is a tricky jump to make because it's hard to tell where the platform ends with this ladder. And you have to make this jump like perfect to get this. There we go. I forget how many of those are. I think it's 10, but it could be 12. Okay, this is the best place to grind for Whoop. So just walk in and out of here. Shoot the thing as soon as it hatches. And get just oodles of noodles and badoodles. Holy cow, how many 1-ups was that? Like 4? It was at least 2. Oh shit. You know what? How many lives do I have now? 6. I think I had 4 before. Because if I get 2 1-ups out of one of those things, it's going to be tough to tell how many lives it is if I do decide to do the 1-up counter for this. I don't know. How about this? I won't do the 1-up counter in this video because I need to get this video up as soon as I'm done recording it. Because I'm recording this like it's 11- WHAT?! I looked away for a second! Oh my gosh! What?! Is this the first time I'm ending a Mega Man video in the middle of a stage? Yes! Yes it is! Bye guys! Next time on Mega Man 7 we'll finish Cloud Man stage. Jeez, I looked away for a second to look at the time, and I died! Like, ugh. You know, of course, man. That's such an of course moment.